Hello, welcome to science lesson. Today, chapter 9, weather. There are three sections here. Section 1, water in the air. Section 2, severe weather. Section 3, forecasting the weather. Today, section 3. Forecasting the weather. Weather forecast is a prediction of weather condition over the next 3 to 5 days. Meteorologist is a person who observes and collects data on atmospheric conditions to make weather prediction. Weather forecasting technology. Meteorologists need to measure various atmospheric conditions such as air pressure, temperature, precipitation, humidity. Use the weather balloons. Temperature, precipitation, humidity, and air pressure. As you see here, students, first precipitation, we have to remember that. That means snow, rain, sleet. One comes from cloud to earth, we call precipitation. Humidity, the water molecule in the air, we call humidity. All right, weather balloons carry electronic equipment that can measure weather conditions. Measuring air temperature and pressure. First, the thermometer. As you see here, thermometer. Thermometer, let me here, thermometer. Tool used to measure air pressure. Inside the thermometer, there is mostly alcohol and mercury. When temperature increases, the alcohol or mercury expands. That means the level of mercury and or alcohol rise up. So we can measure the what air temperature. Barometer is an instrument used to measure air pressure. Also here we are using what? Mercury also they can use. All right, measuring wind direction. Wind direction can be measured by using a wind sock. As you see, it is wind sock. So it is showing what air direction. Measuring wind speed. An instrument used to measure wind speed is called anemometer. Remember again here. Thermometer. A tool used to measure air temperature. Please remember. Barometer is an instrument used to measure air pressure. Wind direction can be measured by using wind sock. An instrument that in wind speed, an instrument used to measure wind speed is called anemometer. It is an anemometer. Alright. Reading and weather map. Isobar are lines that line, as you see, is called isobar. Isobar are lines that connect point of equal air pressure. Air pressure mostly it is something relationship between altitude. H or L represent area of high or low pressure. This is our section. Let us solve together our section review. There are 5 questions. First question, in your word. In your own word, write a definition for each of the following terms. Thermometer, barometer, anemometer. Question 2, which of the following instruments measure in air pressure? Thermometer, barometer, anemometer, wind sock. Question 3, how does radar help meteorologists forecast the weather? Question 4, if the 75 Fahrenheit is on other kind of thermometer outside, what is the temperature in degrees in Celsius? That means 75 Fahrenheit change into Celsius. Critical thinking. Question 5. Applying concept, why would a meteorologist compare a new weather map with one that is 24 hours old? Let us solve all questions. Question 1. Question 1. What is question 1? In your own word, write a definition for each following terms: thermometer, barometer, and anemometer. Thermometer, a tool used to measure air pressure. Barometer is an instrument used to measure air pressure. An instrument used to measure wind speed is called anemometer. This is going to be answer of question 1. Question 2. Understanding ideas. Which of the following instruments measure air pressure? Thermometer, barometer, anemometer, windsock. For air pressure, it is going to be, of course, barometer. A barometer is an instrument used to measure air pressure. Answer will be, of course, B. Alright. Question 3. How does radar help meteorologists forecast the weather? Isobar, as you see, those lines we call isobar. Isobars are lines that connect points of equal air pressure. H and L represent area of higher or low pressure. Question 4. Question 4 is a bit different because it is not question from grade 8. This one from grade 9, chapter 12. You can find detail from there. If it is 75 Fahrenheit outside, what is the temperature in degrees Celsius? We can apply that formula, but of course before that we have to know the type of thermometer here. Otherwise we cannot solve it. There are three type of thermometer we are using: Fahrenheit, Celsius and Kelvin. In our daily life we are using Celsius. Let us check first Fahrenheit. According to Fahrenheit thermometer, water freezing, that means liquid water change into ice in 32 water freeze. What about room temperature? 68. In Celsius thermometer, room temperature is 20. In Celsius thermometer, water is in 0 degree change into ice. Water boiling in 100 degree in Celsius, but in Fahrenheit 212. Our body temperature in Celsius it is 37, but in Fahrenheit it is 98.6. What about Kelvin? According to Kelvin thermometer, water freezing 273 and water boiling 373. So there are three type of thermometer again here. According to Fahrenheit, water freezing 32, room temperature 68, Fahrenheit here, water freezing 32, room temperature 68, body temperature 98.6, and water boiling 212. What about Celsius? Water freezing 0 degree, room temperature 20. Our body temperature 37, water boiling 100. According to Kelvin, water freezing 273, room temperature 293, our body temperature 310. And Kelvin, water boiling 373. That means 20 in Celsius equal 68 in Fahrenheit or 293 in Kelvin. Alright, the question is, how we can 75, what is 70, where is 75 here? Something here. Change into Celsius. It's going to be something here. That means 75 here, as you see, more than 68, less than 98. Here it is going to be between 20 and 37. Alright, we are going to use that formula, students. Alright. How we can use? We can write first our formula. What is our formula? Celsius, that means Celsius thermometer equal 5 over 9 time Fahrenheit, that means Fahrenheit thermometer, minus 32, according to formula. We are apply that formula. Alright, we wrote our formula first. Then we will apply. Celsius equal 5 over 9 times Fahrenheit minus 32. Fahrenheit meaning 75. 75 minus 32. 5 over 9 times 75 minus 32, it is 43. 5 times 43, it is going to be 215. 215 over 9, it is going to be 23.8. That means here, student, 75 Fahrenheit here is going to be 24.8. It is almost 24 degree. All right. Our answer will be 23.8. Our last question. Applying concept, why would a meteorologist compare a new weather map with one that is 24 hours old? Meteorologist would compare a new weather map with one 24 hour old to see how fast a front is moving. So students, we have already finished all section. Chapter 9 finish. Please write everything in your notebook and subscribe.